Deep down in us, we find what makes us function, what makes us human, our proteins. And now, we see them like we've never seen them before. This is one of the smallest, yet one of the most important organs in our bodies. Without it, we would not be able to stand up or walk around. Without it, everything would be silent. This is the inner ear. In the Human Protein Atlas Project, proteins are being studied and used to visualize our organs in completely new ways, so that researchers like Francois Lallemend can experience their field of expertise with new eyes.
It's very, very beautiful. I mean, this is in mouse, but in human, it's exactly the same thing.
The inner ear is a very small bony structure of about 1 centimeter long in humans, in the temporal bone filled with fluid.
So the function of the inner ear is actually multiple. You have on one side the cochlea for the audition, but on the other side, a much less known organ is this vestibular system, which is responsible for the sensation of balance, so basically how you can keep your position in space.
The cochlea and the vestibular system consists of two critical cell types, sensory cells or hair cells, as you see around the edges in green and yellow, and neurons, as seen in red.
So on this 3D picture, you can see the whole inner ear. The whole thing is beautiful, which is usually very difficult to appreciate, is the 3D architecture also of these end organ here, which are the base of the semicircular canals, which are responsible for your 3D orientation of the head. And with this technology, it's definitely possible to only target few cells at a time and to follow the projections in every direction here. Now you only have a focus on the hair cells, and if you can count them, it means also that there are not so many. The problem is that there are so few that if you lose hair cells on a particular frequency, then you will lose that frequency.
The frequencies of sound follow the cochlea like the ivories on a piano, with the high frequencies at the bottom and the low at the top. Damage to the inner ear can not only lead to a loss of hearing, but also imbalance, tinnitus, and vision impairment.
So the interest of these images in our research is to visualize the complexity. So you need to have an overall view of what you are actually studying. And that's very impressive to have a 3D picture for that.
When we explore our world in new ways, we discover new things about us, about life itself. And now we see our proteins like we've never seen them before.